No
Yeah,
problem.
we are live.
All right, all right. So good morning, everybody, and thank you all for joining us for this session today. We're very, very happy to be here, and on behalf of Dhanan Sagar Academy of Architecture, we are happy to have this special session for the parents and students of SSMRV College, Bangalore. So we are very happy for all of those who have made it here today. I think it's going to be a very interesting session, and we're looking forward to all of you all being as interactive on this session as possible. Just to start off, it'll be interesting to know which class you all are studying in. If you all have finished class 12, or if you all have just entered class 12, or if you all have completed class 10 and entering class 11. So whichever class you're in, it would be interesting if you all let us know what class you're in, and then we'll take it from there. All right. But in the meantime, what I would like to do is I would like to introduce the panel out here. We have Professor Mamta N, who's an assistant professor. We have Professor Shabbir Lahiri, who is the associate professor, and both of them are representing Dhanan Sagar Academy of Technology and Management, the campus at Kanakpura Road. This is for the department, they are representing the department of the School of Architecture. This session is being done along with DQ Labs. DQ Labs is a design, is a coaching center, and we are specialized in the NATA exam, the preparation for that, and giving you the basic information and knowledge about the NATA exam. Today's power workshop. So the agenda is going to be the following. We're going to be talking about Bachelor of Architecture as a program in general, the course content, and the future scope. We will be also covering NATA, the scope, the guidelines, and the exam pattern. We will also be covering, Professor Mamta and Professor Shabbir will also be covering the School of Architecture, Dhanan Sagar, as a promising educational institute. And DQ Labs will take you through a power workshop, which is an awareness presentation on the various creative careers that are possible for students like you. Right. So I think we have a few people who are replying saying that they're from class 12. Good. We need a lot more people to reply. So just for those who have joined in right now, please type in the chat. You can ask your questions. Please feel free to ask your questions throughout this webinar. We'll try and answer them at that time, or maybe address it after a few minutes. But for now, please type in which class you are in. Are you in class 11, class 12? Have you completed class 12 and looking forward to the NATA 2020 exam, which is on the 29th of August? So please feel free to type in, and over to the Dhanan Sagar team to start off with the presentation. So Professor Mamta, would you like to start off?
Yes. Yeah. Good morning, students. I'm Mamta, as already Dion introduced. I'm assistant professor from School of Architecture, DSATM, the second campus, the Dhanan Sagar second campus. So not many of you will be in state of mind, not knowing what career to choose, because the thing is not about all the careers you will have enough information has to decide for you to, you know, which career path to choose. I know it also depends on what kind of ability, what kind of creativity or talent you have. So today we are here to brief you about the kind, the way the architecture is, and if you have those inbuilt qualities or those flair towards architecture, so then you'll it'll be you know, it'll throw light on as to what you have to choose and what path you have to take for your career. So that's why we are here to let you know about what architecture is and what are the different fields that architecture gives you. So right now I'll just share a small presentation. Okay. Is the screen visible? Shabi, sorry, is the screen visible?
Mamta madam, the students have not joined.
No, they all will be in YouTube, sir.
YouTube, huh?
Yes.
Yeah. So, yeah, madam, you can, your screen is visible and you can go on presentation mode.
Sorry for the disturbance. Yeah. I just go ahead with the presentation.
Sure.
Yeah, as I told you, we are from School of Architecture, from Dayanansagar Academy of Technology and Management, the campus 2. And this is the building or the structure where our SOA, this is the dedicated department for a School of Architecture in Dayanansagar College. This is our block. And I'd like to give a small introduction about our founders. As you know, the names itself says it's Dayanansagar Institutions. So late Dayanansagar is the founder of our institutions. They basically had a very moral philosophy has to spread the education. So they, I mean, not only technical education, they have been part of all kinds of education, medical, nursing, and management. So I mean, the Dayanansagar group of institutions are spread, they have the wings spread all over. And this is our vice chairman, Premchand Sagar, and this is our secretary, Gali Swami. This is our dynamic principal who heads our DSATM. So all the branches are under him. So even we are part of DSATM. And this is our director, Gadam D. Ramesh. So the whole, I mean, he heads the architecture department in DSATM. Sir has been, you know, he's he has an approach, like the holistic approach, where teaching, learning, you know, are done in a way, you know, very differently, and he's a very committed and a very qualified person. He is a graduate from IIT, and his visions are very foresighted, and I mean, he's always encouraging and motivating students. He himself has a great practice for more than 25 years, and he's been you know, done projects all over India, and very big, large projects. And he's always, I mean, he's also traveled almost all around the world. And so we all are very happy, you know, that we are under him. And then this is about the vision and mission of our architecture school. Like where, you know, we, it's not just about architecture or the teachings of architecture that we are giving our students. It's basically as a person, you know, the kind of knowledge that you imbibe or that you get in DSATM, it's like one it's a kind of overall development that our vision and mission are looking at. And this is about our DSATM. It was established in 2012. It's a 8-year-old college now, and we impart 5 years, five-year course of architecture degree, and our intake is around 60 students per year, and it is affiliated to BTU, Belgaum, and all architecture courses are recognized by Council of Architecture, and our DSATM was a NATA center in 2015, and this is for all the students where this is in general has to, if you have to take admissions for BR or Bachelor of Architecture in any college as such, these are the criteria. I think most of it you will know, but otherwise also I'll just tell you. Either you have to have your physics, maths and chemistry as a combination in your plus two or PU, or you can also come from a diploma background, 3-year diploma background that is done after your 10th or SSLC. And you should also write the NATA exam. I mean, you should clear the NATA exam. That is when you will be qualified for any kind of architecture course in any college in Karnataka. And this is just a brief on the kind of subjects. I'll just read the names. In my presentation also, I'll be explaining as to what exactly we deal in these subjects. See, these are our core subjects. First thing is about architectural design. So architectural design is part of your subject from first semester till the 10th semester, because design is our core element, like where you all the designs come under architectural design. Then next is the materials and methods in building construction, like where you will be studying about the different materials and different technologies that is used for construction, and about then history of architecture. This you will study up to five semesters from first to five. So where all different kinds of architecture you will be learning, right from Hindu, or Stone Age, Islamic, contemporary, Renaissance. So all the kind of different history of architecture you will be studying. Then theory of architecture. Theory of architecture is something like the grammar that is required for architecture, where you will be, there are like a set of guidelines, like rhythm, repetition, balance, symmetry, so scale. So there are many things that guide our design principles. So those things will be taught in theory of architecture. And yes, building structures, it is a structural subject or where you will be learning about the loads and the calculations that is required for a building or a structure. Then comes the building services, where you will be learning about the kind of lighting, plumbing, acoustics. So all those you will be learning under building services. Then we have something called as communication skills. That is only in first semester, where you will be taught to develop your communication skills. Then you have the basic design and visual arts, where your artistic skills will be enhanced. All the kinds of different medias you'll be exposed to, the pen, rendering, painting, and all those. And we have model making, because model making is a very important part of architectural design, because whatever you are creating, we would like to see it in a model. So we have the model making classes. Then we have the graphics, where you'll be taught to draw all the perspectives and all those constructions. Then yes, landscape again is a stream, part of architecture, where we will be dealing with the unbuilt area of the project. So where all your trees, water bodies, hardscape, street furniture, so all these come into existence. Then yes, we have to have a slight knowledge of site surveying and leveling. Though we'll, there are people, people who will do it, but we will have to have, fair knowledge about how the leveling and the surveying done on the site. Then we have the climatology, where we will be looking into the climatological aspects as to the temperature, precipitation, the weather conditions of that place. Then we have the contemporary architecture, where we'll be looking into the modern day buildings and study about it. And yes, sociology and building economics, because we design it for people. So we have to know their economic and sociology background. So that is again introduced as a subject. Then we also have the urban planning, where we move move ahead from the building, where we cater to the needs of a group of people, or urban design, or a city scale kind of projects. Then we also have to have a fair knowledge on specification, quantity surveying, and the kind of costing and the quantities that's involved. And yes, to do all this, now it's the software that is taken up. So we have the computer applications or the CAD that is taught in college. So we also teach them the CAD, Google SketchUp, Photoshop, Rhino, Grasshopper. So we have a various number of softwares which we will be teaching you people as part of your curriculum. And we also have the working drawing, because whatever you design has to be executed on the site. So the skill of drawing or will be taught in college. So basically, these are the drawings which will be read in the sites by the site engineers. So those preparations will be taught to you. And yes, interior design, which is again part of architecture, where you will be taught about the interiors, the right from the flooring to the ceiling, the kind of materials that we are using. So all that will be taught in a interior design. It can be a boutique, it can be a restaurant, it can be a coffee shop. So you have a lot of scope even for interior design, as you all know. Then we have something called as professional practice. If you have to start up your own firm, or even if you're working under practicing architect, there are a set of rules when you're signing an agreement or a contract. So those will be taught in professional practice. And project management, project management is again a different wing, where our architects specialize in project management. Every project, because has to have a project manager who will be managing the project, and he'll be between the client, coordinators, and the architecture team. Okay, and we also have the constitutional law, because we are guided by law. And yes, the last thing is the internship, where one semester, the students will be asked to intern under an registered architect. And these are some of our elective subjects. These are the elective starts from the third semester, these are the listed kind of topics. Each and every student who has any kind of flair towards these, then he or she will choose one of these subjects as an elective. So you can see the various fields that is it gives you an opportunity to learn. So right from architectural photography, which is again taken as a profession by so many of them. Then we have the vernacular architecture, visual communication. Then we have the environmental responsive architecture, product design, heritage documentation, those who are really interested in studying the heritage monuments. Then we also have something called alternative building technology, you'll study about the various technologies that is used other than the normal conventional way of construction and the normal materials. So those things. Then in digital architecture, as I told, here you'll be learning about the Rhino, Grasshopper, those kind of softwares. And we also can specialize in architectural lighting. Only architectural lighting, people can just take it as a profession. So if you have some art galleries, museums, so you need a consultant or an architect who just designs only the lighting layout as to how the sculpture has to look beautiful or whatever. Okay, so then we also have the culture and built environment, where we study how the culture responds to the kind of built environment, the Rajasthan has a different kind of houses, how our villages have a different kind of houses, the Banavasi, the old the Stone Age or whatever. So how the culture impacts, so those things we'll be studying. And the geographical information system, that is the GIS. Then if somebody is interested in high-rise buildings, then that. Then biomimicry, this is again a very new field. So how nature is inspiring our buildings. Then about photography, then architectural journalism. So a few have a flair of journalism, but we need people with architecture background to write about our projects or our buildings. So they make a better better writers for architecture magazines or architecture journalism. Then adaptive reuse of building, then research writing and study tour. The study tour is again a very important part of our curriculum, because architecture cannot just be studied within four walls. Okay, this is our team, as I mentioned. This is our director and professor, Gadamdi Ramesh. Then this is they are our professors, Shivalinga Gowda sir and Mamta Gunagar. So each one are professed with their own identity. Shivalinga Gowda sir has a lot of degrees, and he's also has a very good professional industry experience. So he's been guiding and motivating students throughout. And Mamta Gunagar, ma'am, she is very experienced. Even she has a good amount of practice experience, so which is actually helping the students. And here are our associate professors. Again, each one of them have professed in their own fields. Here is a team of assistant professors. So we have all the professors and assistant professors from IIT, SEPT, and with all various backgrounds, specialized a master's degree in landscape, habitat design, urban design. And we have professors who have been doing PhD, pursuing PhD. Diti Muni, she's doing her PhD from American University. So we have all kinds of professors who can actually assist the students in their career, in has an all-round development. And we have a very good visiting faculty team, because these people keep us in line with the kind of market situations that is happening. All these visiting faculty: Anil Dubey, Ravi Ramchandra sir, Govind Rao sir, Vagish sir, Sudesh Kumar. So all these people have their own offices, and they do projects all over India. Anil Dubey sir is almost 65 plus now. So we are very glad that he's visiting our college, and he's been guiding our students from very long time. And so these people tell us actually what is happening in the market, and the students are trained to be in term with the actual scenario of what is happening outside. Yeah, these people are also our visiting faculty team. And these are some of the new courses that I mentioned, the digital architecture and biomimicry. So we've been calling experts from for students to be acquainted with this knowledge. And these are some of the proctoral forms that we have, to keep the students and the parents intimated about their thing, about their wards. And this is the internal marks card. And this is about the result analysis. So far we have been doing very good as of results. In the 10th semester, 9th semester, it's almost 100%. Not even a single student has failed. So that way we have been having very good results. Year to year, it's been the percentage is increasing. These are our toppers of 2018. And this is some of the projects what we do. So this was our 8th semester project, urban design project, where the students were asked to study the Someshwara temple area in Alsur. And this is just a glimpse of just to show how our urban design drawings are done and built. And this is a part of our on the right hand side, what you're seeing, those are your theory of architecture sketches. So as I mentioned, where you'll be studying about the symmetry, balance, definition, so all those. So each elements are understood through sketches. So students adapt different rendering techniques. Some do dot rendering, pen rendering, and some go with watercolors, poster colors. And again, here on the right hand side, what you see, the history of architecture, the buildings at Chandigarh and your Eiffel Tower. And these are some of the work done in your basic design and art appreciation classes, where they had an exercise of folk fusion. So you can just see like how this photographs were given to the students, and the photographs they have imitated. Each student has taken a different way to portray it. So you can just see like how creative and how nicely the faculty have inspired them to do this. So here also, I think you can just make out like how, you know, three different students with three, but it's the same photograph. So you can see. So it's not going to, I mean, no, the creativity has no boundaries. Each one thinks very differently. So the same here. And yes, we have all different kinds of experiments being done in art classes. You can see the just orange piece, how it is molded and what are the different shapes and how you can, get into different media, how it was done in clay and how it is done in paper and how it is sketched. So so basically, you know, your whole creativity is enhanced and molded, cherished, nourished at our School of Architecture in DSATM. So you will emerge as a full-fledged architect. Like all your creativity will be really boomed. So these are the initial exercises, actually, what you do it in your first and second semester. Okay. And all these, we have our model making studios, like where, these POP casts were done. So different molds. And so all our teachers are in, they hold your hands and everything. They push you to do all the things, as to just widen your talent. And these are some of our thesis projects, our final year students. So this is how, like, how you evolve a concept, and then these whatever, like, you have to imagine each and every space that you're going to design. Let it be a corridor, let it be a outside seating. So these are some of, just to show you the glimpse as to how your imagination can be put into, sketches. And this is again a blind school done by one of our final year student. So like you can see like how the forms evolve, how they're taking shape. So all those. And this is by one of our fifth semester students, Sports Hub. So see, you can see here that, he's he used all the software. All this is done in Rhino and Grasshopper. So you can see not everybody will be, really good at hand. But once you have the imagination, you have these softwares, these days, which can bring out your ideas. It can be easily transformed into these views and models. And this is again a fifth semester student work, the architecture college that he had designed. And as I told you, study tours are a very important part of architecture. So we have been conducting national and international tours. We had national tours. We had been to Pondicherry, Delhi, Agra, Fatehpur Sikri, then Aurangabad, then Ahmedabad. Then international tours, yes, so we had been to Singapore, Malaysia, Dubai, Vietnam, and Cambodia. And recently, we had been to Bhutan. And we also have, have the newsletters that has been released every year, like where we showcase our students' work and achievements. And we also have the advisory board meetings that where from other college and COA people come and inspect us, and they also tell us as to how how we have to go ahead and on our curriculum and if anything has to be bettered. And these are some of the pictures of our study tour. Singapore, Malaysia, Maharashtra, Badami Aihole, This is here in Bangalore, the Freedom Park. And this is Abu Dhabi, Dubai. And this is your Pondicherry, then Bidar, Bijapur. Then these are your Vietnam, Cambodia. And this is the Ahmedabad and Jaipur. And this is our recent Bhutan study tour. Like it was like study tours are not just you know, just a tour, but here like we have the team, like we actually went there and met those architects. It's like a proper study kind of atmosphere. It's not just visiting the place, we also get the architectural background, the kind of you know, the development or the culture of the place, and then how, what are the building material, what are the techniques. So like we actually you know, study it like properly and get back the students. And we also have the lot of expert lectures that we've been arranging. These are like from the past just 2 years, like on building services. Then this alchemy, I mean, this was on urban agriculture and game designing. And a lot of stress is given on sustainability aspects in School of Architecture in DSATM. Then on interior design. Then we also had Shahrukh Mistry. Maybe he's a very famous architect. So we had a talk by him. Then Ganesh Kattepur sir, he's like one man who's been doing all these structures with soil stabilized blocks and other things. So we had expert lectures from them. So these are some of the images of the expert lecture. This I told has the gaming and the urban agriculture thing. And this is about the building services where, you know, fire, public health and engineering and PHE and electrical. So we have experts coming and speaking about it. And we also had Stephen Ward, architect from Australia. Like he spoke to us about how the concepts have to be evolved and how you shape the concepts into the architectural projects. So it's not only the Indian architects or, you know, we have been calling experts from all over the world. And we also have this parents teachers meeting. And these are some of the other workshops, like which will go on like for some 2 to 3 days. Like this order and built environment, we had a team from SEPT Ahmedabad. Like who came and taught our students for a week. And this was a project done by students in second semester where they had actually done with using mount boards, they had done the swing. So like you can see all the people hanging, like it could take the human load. It was really done very well. And so, I mean, where, you know, the engineering meets architecture kind of experiment. And these are some of the images of this order and built environment, like where you actually study the light and shadow and, you know, so they're making all this small models using this straw and thing. And all these were happening when I actually the live classes were happening. But from the last March where we actually have the lockdown and we have online classes. So, but SOEA is not, you know, just keeping quiet. So we have been arranging a lot of webinars through which we are transferring the knowledge to our students. And we have been we approached our own alumni students. Like we are very proud to tell that, you know, most of our students are well placed. They have their own offices. Many of them are pursuing their careers abroad. And many of them have, you know, opted for master degrees in very good renowned universities outside, and they have been practicing there also in UK, US. So we approached a team of them, and they did alumni webinars, a series for 3 days. And we have also had an opportunity to call people like Thomas E. Michael from from Australia, and we had Sukanya Mishra, who is an urban designer in Tokyo, Japan. And we had Sandeep Durbalapur, who spoke on building performance. So all these have been, webinars have been happening, in this March, April months. And we have, as I mentioned, Shivalinga Gowda sir, he has multiple degrees. He has his master's in landscape. He has his law, also has a degree. So where sir guided the students on the constitution law. And we also had Professor Radha conducting a webinar by the director of town planning, Murli. And not only that, we also focus on the kind of because as the lockdown started, we could sense that our students are going through some kind of stress because they were not supposed to go out of the house and all the time online classes and many things, they had to deal with themselves. So we also stress on giving workshops as to, where they can start thinking positively and, deal with their stress levels. So we conducted a seminar by Srijit Krishnan, who is a peak performance coach, who did a seminar on emotional fitness. And as I told in SOA, we stress on the green or the sustainability aspect as such. So we have something called as Go Green Initiative. So where we made the students have a competition, the essay competition and the illustration competition. And we also have these lecture series, every week a professor will be talking about sustainability aspects and so that the students will keep themselves updated with the sustainability aspects. And these are some of the images where we've been giving certificates, and these are the students' feedback on every the guest lecture or the workshops that happens. And this one, we're very proud to tell that our students have won national design competitions. This is a very renowned architect, Raj Rewal, and that's our student. It was a competition, it was a national level competition where they had to redesign a street in Hyderabad, the Patragati Street. And our students had done a wonderful job and they won the second prize of six semester students. And here we can see around 14 students of our fourth semester, they had got selected for their poster design for the international conference. And one of our students, Sahas, he won the best poster award also. And not only that, we are also involved in a lot of social activities. Our students are, they do a lot of social activities through NSS and other things. So here, I think if you just pass by this Kanakpura Road, then near the Konankunte, we have painted the street, where it gives an awareness on environmental pollution. And these are the soldier who died in this Pulwama attack. So our students visited that place and they did a lot of they went to the school where he studied and they distributed all the stationeries and other things that was required for the government school students there. So not only this, a lot of social other activities we do. We visit the nearby schools. They've actually constructed a few classrooms, painted the classrooms, where they can study, and they spend the whole day there along with them doing the activities, teaching them a lot of things. So we've been really very active in almost all the aspects. And these are some of the competitions that we have won. The national, we have something called as NASA for architecture students, the National Association of Students of Architecture. So that's where all the colleges from all over the India, they meet and they have competitions once in a year. So we have been constantly participating, and these are some of the entries that we have done. You have something called a Nari Gandhi Trophy, Landscape Trophy, Hardcore Trophy. So we have been participating in all the streams. And not only that, yes, again, we push students who are in kind of sports. We ourselves conduct sports day every year, and we have been participating in all the intercollege sports events and we are bagging, prizes everywhere. So, and yes, when it comes to our studios, we have a very interactive studios. We don't make it like mundane, where you are just stuck in the classroom and you are given some problem and you're expected to just produce designs on your paper. No, we we have a very interactive sessions. This was they had to design a project in Srirangapatnam. So the students had to be taught as to how the Srirangapatnam, history of it. So they did a skit so that they will understand it in a better way. And these are again some urban design studio projects. And not only that, what were the urban design studio projects? We also documented it like a book release. And this book was very well appreciated by many colleges and many renowned architects. Like it was a proper documentation. And not only that, yes, as I told, we are there everywhere. So we also have our culturals. So our students are part of every fest. And that was in a very different and way. And yes, as I told, the building materials, building construction subject, we take them to site. So where they actually see the actual site constructions and how it is happening. And the same way when it comes to interiors, we have taken them to these interior studios, like where they see how the kitchen works, how the wardrobe works. So all these are part of their curriculum. So it's not like unlike your other branches, where you are taught everything inside the classroom. Yes, and this is some induction program that we usually conduct for the first semesters, where we have all these photography heritage walk design skit. So we take them in and around Bangalore itself, and we make them, we have a properly scheduled theme and timetable working for them. So, and these are some of the programs that we conduct for our own college students. And yes, these are again. And these clay modeling and all you can see. Then the first semester tours. Manjirabad. And these are some of the furnitures, what you can see. It's a life-size furnitures that they have designed. So in carton boxes. And these are the small models so that they get into the scale of the human size. And this is our every batch that passes out and with the faculty. And this is our infrastructure. We have a very good established computer lab with all the softwares installed. And we have a material museum right from a brick to the wire and the bulb, like everything is displayed there so that the students have an idea as to how the tile is, what the thickness is, what the glass size is, how is it. So to get the material feel and look of it. We also have the seminar halls, the studios. We have a very good department library. We have the model making room. And this is the alumni meet we conducted, like where are all architects, the past out students who have established themselves. They come, they motivate the students. They tell their experiences. So yeah, again, the parents teachers meeting. And as I told, yeah, we are into all kind of celebrations also, the Onam celebration, the cultural events that happen. Then we have the Spectrum Weeks going on. And these are some of the cultural events of ours, which was showcased in Deccan Hall. And this is our Holi celebrations. And these are some of the projects that our alumni students have done in Bangalore International Airport. And we also had this open house organized. Or anybody could come and see our, because all our students' work are displayed in the exhibition hall. We have an exhibition hall, like where from the first semester till the 10th semester, all their, right from their models to their design work and the MMBC work, the BD work, models, everything will be displayed. So we had open house where, you know, all the students could walk in and have a look at it. And we also conduct these summer schools where the plus two students come join in for a for a 4 weeks kind of classes where we teach them the basics of the art and appreciation kind of works. This is something we had done with the DSBA, that is the business administrative team, like where we had a 4 day session. Like these are some of the works done by them, and we also have the consultancy approach. I mean the industry experts. So MOU was signed between them, like our two famous architects, that is Jairam and Raviram Chandra sir, who have, I mean, they have their own firms, the Prakriti Architects and the Space Redefined. So we have the MOU signed between us and between SOA, School of Architecture, and these people. And this is the MOU with DSBA. And these are some of the firms where, you know, all our students are settled. We are very happy to tell that all our students have placed well. And these are some of the very renowned firms where they are associated with. Right from Zurong to Atkins to MA Architects to Archicor. So we have our students, doing very well. And these are some of the abroad universities where our students have pursuing their masters. Recently, we also got Roshni Gera, one student who got a recognition, I have not mentioned it here, from REBA, the Royal Institute of British Architecture. So she was, she had got a recognition from there for her excellence study. And this is how our department walls look. None of our walls will be actually blank. So each wall has something to tell. And these, that's a Vitruvian man. If you join architecture, you will know what who is Vitruvius. So that man has been done in waste plastic bottles. And so you can see that is the famous Zaha Hadid on the right hand side. And all these, the left-hand side, with waste hood and carton sheets, they had done the seats and seating place. Okay. So, yeah, that's it in the presentation. I'll just play a small video for you all. Just stay on.
Is it the scene? No, you'll need to share your screen.
Is it seen?
Yes, it can be seen. Could you please remove your headphones? It should work. Thank you.
I guess I'll stop the share. Hello?
Yes, no. You can stop the share.
Yeah, stop. Yeah, that's it about SOA. And now our Professor Shabir sir will guide you on the career guidance that's for architecture students. I'd like Shabir sir to take it over.
Can you see the screen, sir?
Yes, it can be seen. You can make it on presentation mode.
Yes, it is seen.
Yeah, it can be seen. Okay, so...
put it on slide share, sir.
Yeah. So, good morning, friends. I'll just briefly talk to you about what is the future of architects. Okay. So we know, we understand that architecture is nothing but the art and science of building. Okay, and also it has to understand that it is not just art, but there is also technology and a lot of other things which are involved. So an architect, he can design from a macro level, like a city or urban scale, and also he can go to micro level. That is, small constructional details or furniture like that. Okay, so now if you see this particular flower, can you somebody tell me which building is based upon this design of a flower or lotus? Anybody can take a guess? Can you hear me? The students? Okay, so if you see this particular plan, it is also based upon this lotus, okay? This is the plan of the Baha'i temple. Okay, so it is based upon the idea or a concept of a lotus. So the concept is something very important, okay? That is the initial starting point of any design, right? So this is the final reality of this Baha'i temple that is based upon the design of a lotus flower. Okay, so... the whole thing is about this program is we train people to understand and conceptualize vision into reality, right? This particular building, which is in Delhi, the Baha'i Temple of Worship, like it is open to all religions, okay, any like, you know, whether you are from Islam or Hinduism or Christianity or Sikhism, it is open to all religions, okay, and it's based upon the concept of a flower. So that is how to change your ideas, you know, from a concept to final the construction of this building. That is what we train in architecture. So we make these all these drawings on the, you know, we try to understand, you know, for example, this particular, we see this promenade, like, you know, it is a pathway kind of a thing. So we make all these on the drawings, okay? Like here you can see there is a circular winding road with trees and landscape. We try and make these presentation drawings, or, you know, drawings. These drawings are important method, okay, to communicate ideas and, you know, finally convert them into reality. So that is the whole idea. We make these drawings or plans to finally execute these ideas. So architecture is basically teamwork, okay? It is not just the architect, but he has to interact with the engineers, okay, the landscape architects, the mechanical engineers, electrical engineers, okay, then people who acoustics, lighting and interior design, okay, artists, you know, planner. So this whole thing is a teamwork of which architect is one of the players. Okay, there's a teamwork or a team involved in construction of any design. It is not just an individual, but it is a teamwork. There are a lot of people who contribute to final. There's expertise. Okay, like one person is expert in a landscape, one person expert in structures, one person expert in interiors. So it is a combination of all these skills which finally are used to construct the buildings. So as I mentioned, architects have to work with engineers and, you know, technicians and even clients, okay, to design. So main idea of the architecture is based upon three things, okay. One is it has to be functional. Okay, any drawing or any building has to be functional. Second thing, it has to be safe. It has to, the structure has to be strong enough. Stability is important. And third thing is the aesthetic part. Okay, so it is a these combination of these three parameters, like you have aesthetics, you have structure, and then you have function. So once you combine these three things, then we can say that it is a good building is of a good design. So architecture, it can be into residential scale projects, institutional projects like university campuses or colleges. It can be a commercial kind of a design, like a multiplex or, you know, like that. Okay, so office buildings. So we have to understand what is the need of the client. Okay, what is the requirement of the client is important. And then you have to work with them to get the final design. So as I discussed that most of the, you know, projects we get as architects are residences, okay? And then apart from that, you can, even the government also employs architects, for example, to make all these, you know, airports and bus stations and all that. The government also can employ the architects. And then even architects are involved in education, like we discussed, you know, visiting faculty or tenure faculty, okay? And then they take part in conferences to understand what is the latest trend. Okay, then they can also take part in architectural competitions. Okay, it can be a national level competition, international level competition. Okay, and also they can, like these are the various spheres on which the architect can work on. Okay, these are the various fields. So important thing, you should have a degree. Okay, BR degree is important and should be recognized by the Council of Architecture Delhi. Okay, like you have to register with the Council of Architecture Delhi. Right now, I believe there are about 1 lakh architects who are registered with COA Delhi. Okay. So architecture means it is, you know, a lot of various activities, okay, like model making, okay, or, you know, going to site and doing project management, okay, or making drawings in the office. Talking to clients, okay, it's a range of different you know, work which the architect has to he has to make the specific estimation of the building. What is the estimation of the building? He has to find out Okay, so there is a lot of various activities the architect has to be a part of. And it is not just limited to small buildings, but also to city level also. Okay, like we see Chandigarh. It was designed by Le Corbusier architect. Okay, so architects have also been designing cities on urban scale. Okay, it is not just the plot and you construct a building, but even all cities can be designed by architects. So that is the level. It can, from a small table or a chair to a city. The scale varies. So after completing your architecture, you can become an urban planner. Like, specialize, there's a course for urban planning. After master's in urban planning, you can become a planner, you can become a landscape architect, you can become an interior designer, you can become a project manager, okay, you can become a teacher in a college, you can become a professor. Okay, even you can study structure, you can study structural engineering, okay. After that, so all these are various branching of the profession, like, what all you can specialize in after you complete your BR called graduation. Like, this is a post-graduation level courses. Okay, so I told you, supposing you want to become landscape architecture, you have to do a course in landscape architecture. You want to become if you want to join organizations like Intact, which conserve buildings or old monuments, then you have to join architectural conservation as a course. Then you have to join you can do master's in construction management. You want to become a project manager. Then do a course in urban planning if you want to become a planner. Okay, otherwise, there are architects who have studied MBA. Okay, they have studied MBA and then that also can be done. Okay, so these are the various postgraduate courses available for architecture, specialization. Okay, and in India, we have all these colleges which offer these courses like IITs or SPA or SEPT. Okay, so these are the colleges in India and abroad also. You have colleges in US like Columbia, okay, UCLA, there's a college in Netherlands. So here also, you can go abroad also to study your post-graduation course. And then even if you're still further interested, you can even do your PhD. If you want to do teaching, take teaching as a career, then you can take a PhD, you can pursue PhD also later on. And even after PhD, you can do postdoctoral studies also. Okay, so there's no limit if you want to acquire knowledge. So this is a small project which is done by one of our students, Salman and Shamir. They were students of our college. They graduated in year 2017. They have made this cafe in the Bangalore International Airport. Okay, and within, they are just very young architects, about 30 years of age. And, they have started making all these, cafes and in a short span of time. Okay, so this is the cafe as you are at Bangalore International Airport, okay, designed by our students. So after completing your architecture, you can join these offices, okay, like multinational offices like RSP Architects, okay, Jurong, like these are from based in Singapore, okay, or you can join architects in Bangalore like Chandravakaran Thakur or Christopher Benninger, he's in Pune, okay, Rahul Mehrotra, Bombay. Ashmukh Patel in Ahmedabad, like all these architects, you can join as a young architect, to gain experience. Then after gaining experience for 4 or 5 years, you can start even your own office. Then even you can take government jobs in like HUDCO and, town planning and CITCO and all, you can work for the government also. So if you want to pursue careers, apart from architecture, you can even take photography. Like, some of the architects, after completing their studies, they have become photographers. Or you can become even a model maker. Okay, you can make models for architects, or you can even do perspectives. Okay, like most of these architect offices, they require perspectives to communicate to their clients. So you can even become a person who specializes in making perspective drawings, or you can Okay, or you can even take a part in drama. You can take drama as your field, like you can become a set designer of a film or, you know, like that. So these are the various, it is not just limited to architecture, but there is a lot of, you know, branchings and, you know, there's a lot of overlapping of different professions. So I would like to thank you and I wish you all your best for your career. Over to you, sir, Mr. Dayan.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. You could probably exit your screen sharing.
Yeah, I'll do that.
All right. So thank you so much for talking about the different options that you have in careers in the architecture, as well as all the you know, the potential, the talk about the Dayanand Sagar School. So it was very interesting. And now for the rest of the audience, I would just like to play a small video. Now, this is a 5-minute video, but it's interesting and I'd like to talk you through this video. It's made by a company called Haval. It's an automotive company and they have envisioned what life is going to be like in the year 2050. So the reason why we like this is that there are various aspects of design and architecture that are highlighted in this. And it would be an interesting platform for you to have a look.
So we can't see the screen. Answer.
Sorry, let me just share my screen. Are you all able to see my screen?
Yeah, we can see it now.
Yes. Okay. So here we see various aspects of urban design, right? This is urban design, urban planning. This is architecture that we see around. This is transportation design. The car is transportation design. This is mobility design. This is interior design. Again, urban design. This is game design, video game design. This is interaction design, where they're interacting with their cars. Again, various aspects of interior design, interaction design, communication design, UI, UX design. This is home automation. Again, interior design, architecture. This is landscape design. Again, landscape design, you see, interaction design. Have a look at the signages, the road signages. All right. I just one second. So, was that visible? Did you all find that interesting? Yeah. So it's right. So we hope you found that video interesting. Now, what we want to talk about is that being an architect or a designer, you need to dream, all right? But your dream has to be channeled in the right direction, which means you need to channel your thoughts into the right direction, and then you can be a designer or an architect, all right? So all those areas I spoke about, an architect can do, all right? So let me come down to to a few things. I think since there are just about 10 minutes more, we've been given time till 12:30. So there are about 10 minutes more. So I will do one thing. I will just give you a quick brief about DQ Labs. We've been founded by Umesh and Sean. They're both designers from IIT Delhi. Umesh is an architect and a designer. So he's an architect. He worked as an architect for 3 years. Then he did his master's in design and started designing cars for Jaguar Land Rover and Hyundai Motors and General Motors and all that. So this is one of the areas that you can get into. Now, Umesh is also a TEDx speaker, and Sean is also an inspirational speaker. Now, Umesh is also the co-founder of ExamPlay. And ExamPlay is a specialist in learning design. So now you see the versatility of this of Umesh as an architect. He started off as an architect, went into transportation design, which is automobile design, and today he's designing learning, all right? Methodologies to make you learn better. So this is the possibilities that you have, all right? So I think my screen was not shared. So this is Umesh, who's an architect and a designer from IIT Delhi. And he's also a TEDx speaker and also a winner of the NASSCOM Design for India Award for ExamPlay, which is a learning platform. So this is the versatility of an architect, all right? You can really find your own path, create your own path, and really get into a lot of professionalism in your career. So I'm not going to be talking about the potential because that has already been covered significantly. But I would like to just bring about one more point over here, all right? This is a very famous drawing. Some of you may know about it or some of you may not know about it. If you can tell me what this is, please type it out in the comments. I'm not going to spend too much time over it, but this is the first sketch made by an architect called Architect Frank Gehry. And this is his first sketch for this building, all right? So to be a good architect, what you require is to have brilliant ideas, all right? Sketching is also very important, but your sketching should be limited to being able to communicate your thoughts. Okay, so being an architect or a designer, you need to be able to communicate your thoughts effectively. All right. Now, I'm going to skip a few slides going forward from here. All right. So now let me come to this slide. All right. So when it comes to your, hold on. Let me come to this presentation. Okay. Yeah, so now this is Architect Frank Gehry. Now, apart from having good sketching skills, you need to have the ability to understand what is in somebody else's mind and make that a reality. All right. So this is the same architect, Frank Gehry, who's also designed the Facebook complex. All right. So apart from architecture, there's planning or built environment, which is like town planning and interior and space design. All of that has been covered. Now, you are in class 10 or 11 or 12, or maybe you've completed 12, and you want to get into architecture as a career. All right. So there are two very important exams that you need to take. One is the IIT JEE or JEE paper 2. Paper, remember, paper 1 is for engineering and paper 2 is for architecture. So you need to focus on JEE paper 2 and you also need to focus on NATA. All right. Now, using this, you can get into the top schools in India, including the SPAs, the NITs, as well as schools like Dayanand Sagar, right? Now, once you go through these schools, you will have to do 5 years of studies where you can become an architect or you get a BArch degree. And then you can also do a master's in design or a master's in architecture. So all of this has been covered. Now, what I'm going to show you next is about the NATA and JEE Paper 2 syllabus. All right. So typically there is mathematics, there is aptitude, and there is sketching. This is what a typical syllabus looks like. In the case of JEE Mains, it's for 400 marks. And in the case of architecture, it is for 200 marks. All right. Now, if you notice in NATA, the weightage given for the sketching aspect is 125 marks, and the weightage given for physics, chemistry, mathematics, aptitude, all of that put together is about 75 marks. So there is a huge focus on your sketching, all right? Whereas when we look at JEE Paper 2, the weightage for this is about 25%, all right? Or 100 marks out of 400 marks. Now there has been a small change in the syllabus for the sketching. Now this change is only for this year. There's not going to be any physical sketching because of the current situation. So they have altered the syllabus accordingly, all right? Now I'm just keeping a track of the time because I have just about 5 minutes left. So this is a very critical aspect, all right, of understanding what the exam is. Now the next thing what I will show you is what topics you need to study, okay? So for all those of you who are keen on it, this is the website you need to go to. All right. And I'm going to put this here. All right. It's called edge.dqlabs.in. You can register here and you can select your NATA or JEE paper 2 as an option. Now, there are two areas where you need to focus on. Number one is practice, and number two is learn. All right. So what we would recommend now, when it comes to learn, all your topics are over here, including mathematics, architecture awareness, visual spatial ability, mental ability, analytical reasoning, English, design sketching. Also, the entire exam structure is here. Your exam test questions are here, physics, chemistry, math, whatever you need. Absolutely, whatever you need to prepare for the NATA is available here. And let me just show you how it's organized. So for example, if you come into architecture awareness, there are different chapters. Under each chapter, you'll have subtopics and you can go in from one to the other where we talk about everything. All right. Now, all of this is very important for you to be ready. Okay, in terms of the exam. So all you need to do is just go from one topic to the next to understand all this. Okay, so for those of you who are considering NATA either in 2020 or 2021 or 2022, whatever it is, this is where you need to come and study for your NATA exam. Now, we also cover the sketching part of this. All right. I'll tell you how to go into the sketching part of it. When you come to the sketching, you will have all fundamentals, that is perspective, shading, shadows, textures, human figures, animal figures, all of this, okay? You come here, you will get, let me do one thing. You come here, there will be, you know, some theory and information here, and there will also be sketching videos, all right? Giving you, these are live videos, which not live video. These are recorded videos, which probably give you a lot of information about the concepts. So your live classes happen here. All right. So all your concepts are covered in this. Right. So this is how we do it. Okay. I'm just going to skip quickly. But all of this is very important because it helps you design your, it helps you with your theme sketch. Now, these are all fundamentals. Now, in these fundamentals, when you come to the exam part of it, you will have to do theme sketches. So theme sketches will be a question like, you are a bird flying over architectural ruins. What do you see? And you see, you need to draw this, imagine and draw this. All right. So similarly, you will need to draw, there'll be other questions. And these questions also, we have described how you can start from absolutely a blank piece of paper to reach the final output where you apply what you have learned, your shading, shadows, textures, human figures, animal figures, all of that. All right. So this is how you finish your drawing. Everything is here. Then we also suggest that you come to the practice section. There are All India mock tests, there is past year question papers, JEE mock tests, whatever you need is available over here. All right. So I think I would like to stick within the time limit. 12:30 was the time given to us. But just on another final note, for those of y'all who would like to get a little more information regarding this, all right, we have a special webinar, all right? We have a special webinar today. I think the best option for me is to just post this information, all right? I'm going to post it in this message here. Hold on. I'm going to post it here so that okay, so that y'all can go here and participate in this webinar. Yeah, we are running out of time, so I have to cut this short. But if you'll do come for this webinar, you can get a little more information today. Otherwise, you could always connect with us on this number 959-100-1000. And let me do one thing. I'm going to So what I'm going to do is I'm going to share one last link with you. All right. So what you can do is come to this particular link. Okay. There's a free, absolutely free sketching class that's going to be here for you guys. So please. Yeah, you can see this link. So please take the sketching class and you can connect with us and we'll be happy to guide you further. All right. So yes, madam, I've finished my part of this presentation. Would we have any last words from Professor Durga Ramesh or from the Dhanan Sagar team?
Yeah. Sir,
we'll address.
Yeah. Hello, sir. This is a very good presentation by Mamta, Shabir, and Dion. First of all, I would like to thank principal of SSMRV PU College, Mrs. Lakshmi for giving us this opportunity to actually have an interaction with their students, and also thank our management of Dhyanand Sagar institutions for giving us this opportunity to reach out to PU colleges, and also thank DQ Labs for associating with us for DQ Labs, as you all know, that they actually train students for preparing for NATA. And on this platform, I thank and thank very much for hosting this Zoom platform, Mr. Dion, for having given this opportunity. So that's all. And we are actually kind of blessed that we have got this opportunity to share with the PU college students, the principal of SSR MERV College, and Mamta N to actually making this happen on this day. So we continue to do this. We have outreach programs like this. We do conduct outreach programs. We have a calendar. We also share the calendar with you later on. And probably you can also contact, share the contacts of our coordinators, Madam Principal of this college, with your students so that they can come back and kind of gain more knowledge on this. And also, you are also invited anytime to our college so that you can have a look at our campus, which is a beautiful campus just opposite to Art of Living, Ravi Shankar Ashram. This is campus 2, and campus 1 is also there. That is at Kumar Swami layout. We are at campus 2, and we are a young institution, but we are doing our best and doing the kind of getting a lot of feedbacks from various academicians and also industry experts. So this is all I want to say. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Dion, for hosting this. Great. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. I really appreciate the opportunity given by the principal, Ms. Vasant Lakshmi. Thank you so much. Yeah. And and to Professor Durga Ramesh and the DSAT team. Yeah.
Thank you all. I think we can end the session here.